What's up, guys? Jay, more than after kill, and I'm back here on Borderlands 2, and it's episode 2 of today's Sunday Q&A motherfucking Let's Play. And today, we are doing loot midget farming like you guys wanted. Earlier, we did it with Zero, and today, I wanted to test out my luck with Maya, my Siren, because she does seem to get a little bit more legendaries than my Zero does. And my Zero actually got a legendary last episode. I am so happy about that I can finally show you guys something fucking dropping. Goddamn, because my luck fucking sucks. I know people are tired of hearing me say that, but you know what? You know what? The rent is too damn high. Shit. Why do I have a plasma caster out? What is that? What the fuck? Yeah, I guess we'll have the plasma caster out. Don't I have a shock hawk? I thought I had a shock hawk on this class. Where's my shock hawk? Boo! Oh well, we'll just use the slag hawk. The slag hawk! Yeah, baby, the slag hawk. So, let's get right into the motherfucking questions today. And it's from Big Macko. Big Macko says, what age did you start growing your amazing beard and hair? I started growing my beard when I was like 14. I mean, I've had facial hair for a very long time. My hair was long all throughout my teenage years. I don't know if you guys know what an undercut is, but I had one, which is basically where you leave the top of your head long. It's kind of like a skater cut. You leave the top of your head long, and you fucking, you know, you cut the hair underneath really short. So then when you kind of put it in a ponytail, half your head's bald and half your head is long, which, you know, it was cool for the time period. But very, very outdated right now. So I don't have that anymore. I did cut my hair when I was like, what was that? I think I was around, like 19, 18. Somewhere around there I cut my hair. And I regretted it. And when I came back from California, I found out that my barber that I had in Jersey, he died. He died, which is very sad. He cut my hair for a very long time. Very, very cool guy. So, you know, rest in peace, Joe. Joe was the guy that used to fucking, you know, perform miracles on my head. And, like, it was so cool that I didn't even have to shave myself because I would just go in there once a week. And for $20, not only would he, like, you know, shape up my hair, fucking cut it up, trim it up, make sure it looked nice, lush, and wondrous, you know, as awesome as my hair really is, because my hair is actually very goddamn beautiful. And it really is. It's long and flowing and lush. It's kind of like Jesus' hair, fucking. But yeah, it was you know, it was sad, and I was like, you know what, this is the perfect time to grow my hair long, because you know my hair was already kind of long when I was going to cut it, and I was like, yeah, baby, yeah. Ouch, ow, he hurt me. But yeah, I was just trying to fucking, you know, get my hair cut, and it just didn't work, so I grew it out long, and I like it long again. I like the way it's at, you know, because all my hair is 100% long. It's not like an undercut anymore, so I finally have the haircut and the beard that I've always wanted for my entire life. And, you know, yeah, it may make me look like a hippie or biker or Jesus, whatever. You know, I've heard them all, and people, you know, people will judge you when you have long hair and a beard, but you know what? You know what? Fuck them. Because if they don't want to be friends with me because of the way I look, then you know what? I don't want to be friends with them. Because I think they look funny, you know? You look funny with your short hair. Grow your hair, hippie. Or grow your hair, yuppie. What do you want? You know, I don't fucking care, man. Honestly. But, yeah, I've had my hair now for about 4 years, 5 years now. And it's amazingly long. It's all the way down to my ass. I can actually sit on my hair. It's that fucking long, and it's actually pretty amazing. But what I do is when it gets so long, I go to the barber, and I fucking tell him, be like, hey, lop off like 7 inches of it. They do, and they trim it up, and then they put a rubber band around it, and they fucking, I don't know, they seal it up in a plastic bag or whatever, and then they donate it to a thing called Locks for Love, which uses real human hair to make wigs. Oh, look, it's a tasty wound. Woo! But anyway, they take those fucking, you know, the hair that they donate, and they make wigs for kids with cancer, which is a, you know, an amazing way to give back, because, you know, I was blessed with such beautiful, lush, and wondrous hair. But the next question is from Depersonalized. He says, "Hey Jay, you Black Sabbath fan?" "Yes, yes I am." He says, "Are you looking forward to the new album?" I didn't even know they had a new album on the way, which is kind of, you know, it's sad to say because, you know, but Ozzy's old, man. Ozzy's old. Can he sing still? I mean, the last time I went to see Ozzy live, he didn't sound like the Ozzy I remember growing up with, you know? He was more like, he was real slow. You could tell, like, he was holding on to the fucking microphone for dear life like he always does. But, I mean, when it came time to him doing his, like, you know, his patented frog splash jump and fucking hopping around and clapping his arms, you could tell he was noticeably tired and fucking, you know, just ready to call it a day. And I think Ozzy should just be like, you know what, I'm done, man, you know, he's a legend. Why ruin it? Michael Jordan did the same thing, you know? He kept coming back, and eventually he became a fucking butt of a bunch of jokes, which is kind of sad to see Michael Jordan become the butt of a bunch of retirement jokes, but I mean, that's life, isn't it? So, the next question, though, is from Jake Honeydew. He says, "Have you ever gotten so mad at a game that you stopped playing it?" Yeah, Gotham City Impostors was the latest one. I got so mad that they wouldn't fix the fucking game, that it was an amazing game, that I just stopped playing it. I was like, every time I would play it, it would dashboard me out of the game. I couldn't even play a full fucking match because it would just dashboard me. I don't know what the fuck was wrong with the game, but, you know, it was, God damn it, I waited so long! I waited so long for that not to happen, and it still happened. Motherfucker, watch there be a midget here. Watch there be a midget. Fuck it, there's no midgets. No midgets. But, Gotham City Impostors. Another one was Ninja Turtles on the NES. I stopped playing that game for years because of the goddamn fucking, you know, goddamn level where you had to swim through all the coral, and the coral would electrocute you if you touched it, and it was timed, and it was so much, like, little small crevices to guide your Ninja Turtle through that area that it was just, it was literally physically almost impossible. And if you did make it out of there alive, you barely had enough health or turtles left for the type of shit that you faced afterwards. So it was, that was probably one of the most notoriously hard games I've ever fucking played. I remember, the last one I can remember about is, the last one I'm going to mention here is Super Pitfall for the NES. I remember being so excited for that because Pitfall for the Atari was awesome. Played it on the NES. Fucking sucked donkey dick. If you want to see how bad that is, actually go look up, like, the Angry Video Game Nerd. He did a video on it, and I agree wholeheartedly with everything he fucking says in that video. So, let's move on. The next question is from Clutch 354. He says, "Jay, have you ever had a ghostly or paranormal experience?" Yes, yes I have, and I'm not gonna share it with you though. I'm not gonna share it with you because it is too personal for me to do that. I do get personal with you guys a lot, but there are some things that I don't feel like talking about with some people, and I just keep it to myself because I've been doing that for years. I've been doing it for years, and nobody needs to know about my fucking contacts with ghosts, you know? People look at you funny. They look at you funny. But, I'm not going to share that with you guys, but yes, I have had, experiences that I can't explain otherwise, other than it being a paranormal. Not necessarily a ghost, but some type of, not extraterrestrial. This isn't fucking ancient aliens. But, something funny was going on there that I couldn't explain. So, let's move on, though. Tactical Duck says, have you ever been to a different country? If so, what's your favorite? Yeah, I've been to Mexico a couple times. And that's the only country I've really ever been to. I'm pretty sure we were up someplace really close to, Canada at one point. And we might have even crossed in there. I'm not sure. But, it looked like Canada, that's for sure. It was fucking mountainy as a motherfucker and a lot of fucking wilderness. So, I'm going to say Canada, too. But, I guess Mexico would be my favorite because it's the only one that I can actually be sure that I stepped foot in. And, and I'm fucking Mexico, man. It's Mexico. It's, whatever you hear about Mexico is Not true. It's completely worse than you imagine. no, that's only in Tijuana, though. I'm sure there's areas of Mexico that are actually very, very beautiful. You know, particularly, like, you know, where some of the fucking, like, older, like, temples are and shit like that. But I have not been that far into Mexico to know. The only thing I have ever been to was the toilet bowl they call Tijuana. And I don't think I want to go back. I really don't. I just, if I want to go to a hood, I'd rather go to the hood that I'm comfortable with because, you know, if I'm going to have problems, I could call my people and they'll fucking come and take care of it. That's right. That's right. We roll deep. We roll deep in the hood. So, yeah, I guess I would say Mexico, Duck. I guess I would say Mexico. But the next question is from Brendan Freeman. And he says, "Hey, Mac, I enjoy your Borderlands 2 vids. What would you do if you were forced to listen to Justin Bieber?" Well, I don't know anything about Justin Bieber, really. I know that Usher is the guy that fucking takes care of Justin Bieber, I guess. I think that's like his like manager and shit like that. I'm not sure. But I do know Justin Bieber came from YouTube, and he's hugely popular now. I don't think I've ever actually listened to a Justin Bieber song. All I know is that one fucking clip that, like, you know, everybody fucking plays. Baby, 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 baby. That's all I really know about it. But, you know, as far as ever listening to it, it's just never something that I've come across yet. It just hasn't been something that has, you know, really been brought up with me. You know, I don't listen to the radio. I don't fucking go to YouTube videos of things that I don't like. Like, I don't understand why fucking, like, Rebecca Black and Justin Bieber's videos are so highly disliked. If you don't like them, don't watch them. Plain and simple. Like, you don't, if you don't like those person's music, don't go to their video. It's like, I don't understand why YouTube has that. I've said this a lot. I don't even understand why they have a like and dislike button, because if you are the dumbass that's watching a video that you don't like, and you don't have to be on that video because it's on-demand programming, I don't understand it. I really don't. I can't figure it out how people, you know, get away with that shit. Like, just fucking sit there and watch videos just to dislike shit that they don't like. Motherfucker. Wow, am I gonna be able to pick myself up? I don't think I am. I don't know. Can I get that guy? Can I get him? No. Oh my goodness. Come on, Maya. Come on. Am I gonna have to fight every single one of these motherfuckers, man? What am I using on my class mod? What am I using? What class mod am I using? Oh, I don't have my legendary one on. That's why. There we go. Maybe this will be better. Let's go ahead and switch out. I had a Norfleet on me. Why didn't I pull that out? I don't know, actually. That is the mystery question. So, the next question, though, is from Murray Monster. Because, honestly, to answer the other kid's question, I don't know what I would have to do if I was forced to sit and listen to Justin Bieber. I might like it. I like Usher. I'm not afraid to say that I like Usher, man. Usher is amazing. And if Usher picked this kid out, you know, from the internet to be the successor to his throne, then I mean, you know, you gotta give Usher some credit, right? Maybe he knows what he's talking about, because this kid is insanely motherfucking popular. So yeah, next question, though, like I said, it's from Murray Monster. Says, "Mac, what would be what's the first game you ever got?" Oh man, I don't know the first game I ever got, like, owned myself. That would probably be Mario Brothers for NES, because, you know, my fucking Atari 2600 was a hand-me-down. But, I guess it would just be Mario, man. Fucking, that's my first game. Really, really boring. But if you were born in the 80s and you had video games, that was most likely your first game, too. So, you know what? Haters are gonna hate. So, Murray Monster says, if you could have any pet, what pet would you choose? Not a real big pet person. So, I would probably choose a dinosaur, because who wouldn't want to own a fucking dinosaur, all right? I want to own a dinosaur. I want to ride him around, and I want to be like, hey, look, that's my fucking dinosaur. Fuck with me, he is going to fuck you up, bitch. God damn, you don't even know. You don't even know. Shit. Alright, so those of you guys that actually wonder why I come in here to actually lose the enemies that are aggroed on top of me when I get in there. That way, it's a little bit easier for me to make it through this area because it can get very, very, very uncomfortable in here when you're getting hit by a shit ton of fucking enemies. Look at that. Look at all those motherfuckers. Shit. So, anyway, the next question is from Super Minecraft for the win. He says, do you watch TNA or WWE? I do not. I do not. I used to watch wrestling back in the day when I was younger. Back in the, you know, fucking old school days of WWF with The Undertaker and Triple H and fucking Hulk Hogan and The Ultimate Warrior and fucking, you know, just the old school names that were really, really awesome for wrestling. And, you know, I really enjoyed that time, but, you know, now it's like, it just seems kind of cheap. You know, I guess, who's the WWF champion, I guess? Last one I remember that I seen on TV was like, I think it was John Cena? I'm not sure, but, John Cena is a scumbag. I don't like him at all. I think he's like the worst fucking character gimmick they've ever had for any fucking, like, WWF character. It was like, oh yeah, let's get a guy that wants to be Eminem, but have the shittiest fucking rhymes in the world. It's basically Vanilla Ice with tights on. That's what it is. It's Vanilla Tights. Vanilla Tights. That's the new name for John Cena. So, no, I don't watch any of the new wrestling because I think the new wrestling doesn't compare, man. It doesn't have that fucking old school pizzazz and wow factor that the fucking WWF Attitude Era had. That was probably the best time for any fucking, like, wrestling type of deal ever. I really enjoyed that era. But, no, don't watch it. Don't watch it. Sorry, bro. I'm sorry. I wish I watched it for you. No, I don't really give a fuck. ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time. No, I like fucking Law and Order shows. I don't know why. Fucking hate me. I'm old. Whatever. Don't give a fuck. But, get away from me. I give a fuck about that. But, Dylan Prez says, Jay, do you lift, bro? I do not. I am not in the shape that I once used to be. Like, I used to be able to, like, fucking just go out, fucking play football for hours on end and shit like that. But now, you know, I'm old, I have a bad knee, fucking, you know, injuries, my back creaks, fucking, I wake up just feeling like a piece of shit every goddamn day. No, I'm just joking. I wake up and, like, new parts of my bodies are starting to make noises that they never made noises before. It's like, you know, fucking my back is like, I'm like, oh, shit, fucked happened to my back, you know? It's just, you know, it's a part of getting old, and, you know, you don't have the pizzazz and the wow factor that you once had out in the fucking football pitch, the field, whatever you guys want to call it. Hang around with too many fucking English people, goddammit. But, where's he at? Did I just kill him? Nice. That was pretty decent. I like it. Oh, look, he's in here too. Get out of here. We got another fucking stalker coming, though. Come on, you piece of shit. Where's he at? I see him. He's bouncing towards me. Whoop, there we go. Whoop. Alright, making good progress. Oh, shit. It's another one. Where did he come from? And he's hurt. He's hurt, goddammit. Hurt him. Come on, I don't want to waste the fucking... Come on, there we go. I put him down with the old blade hawk to the head. Fuck you, motherfucker. But no, I don't lift, man. I don't have the time. I really want to get back to gym for you know, just to get in better shape. Really, I like to swim. I like to swim a lot. I can, if you put me in a pool, I will swim for like 8 hours before I even realize that I've been in there for that fucking long. But no, as far as lifting, I've never really been a big lifter. Even when, like, back in high school, when I played, like, a little bit of football and shit like that, fucking, you know, I was more of a fucking legs type of guy. fucking work on the calves because I played fucking, you know, I played a little bit of fullback, played a little bit of linebacker, you know, I had to be fast on my feet, but, you know, I just never felt the need to bench press. I have nobody to impress by how much I can lift, like, I just fucking, but you know what, like, when it comes down to actual, like, real world moving and shit, like, I could pick up a fucking, you know, I could pick up a transmission. Oh, it's Jimmy Jenkins. He's not gonna give me shit. Like, I could pick up a fucking, like, me and my buddy, we just fucking, we went, he was, he bought a motor, and, we didn't think about how we were gonna get it back to his house. So, you know, we went to pick it up, and we just fucking, the motor was on a pallet, we just fucking picked that shit up and put it in there. So, I mean, you don't have to lift to be physically strong, so don't let people on the fucking internet fool you and be like, oh yeah, you gotta lift or you're fucking, you know, nobody's gonna give a fuck about you. You're like, fucking, nobody wants to look like a fucking bodybuilder. Well, I mean, like, not the bodybuilders that get toned. I'm talking about, like, the bodybuilders that you see, like, all nasty and ripply and shit. That's fucking disgusting, man. It's fucking gross, alright? And nobody wants that. Nobody wants to see that. Ain't nobody got time for that. Ain't nobody got time for that. And you know what? Nobody got time for any of this shit either. Look at that. Look at all that trash inside that ass. That should be a fucking Black Eyed Peas song. Look at all that trash inside that ass. I'm gonna make sure you don't drop shit. Shit. I am fucking weird. So moving on. The next question is from Ryan Huestis. And I hope I said that name right. If not, oh well. But he says, what do you think is better, Samsung or Apple? You know, I've never been one to pay for name brand shit. I don't really believe in that. But I mean, with electronics, you do get what you pay for. And with Apple, you get a very expensive logo. And Samsung, like I said, I don't carry a phone anymore, so I don't know about smartphones or anything. But Samsung has always sold me a quality product. I've never got a product from Samsung that I was like, oh shit, you hear that burp that came out while I was talking? That is weird. But yeah, anyway, fucking Samsung has always sold me good shit. I've never had a product from Samsung that I was like, man, you know, this sucks balls, a total waste of money. No, but you know, Apple seems to be doing fine, but I don't know, man, that's up to you. It's up to you. But he says, Sony or Microsoft? That's another thing, man. It's personal preference. It's personal preference. I mean, Sony, if you want to put it this way, I mean, outside of the security problems that they've had with their first online foray with, you know, I guess you would call that PSN. They had a little bit of problem with the hacking. But besides that, you know, hardware-wise, Sony has delivered a better product than Microsoft has this generation. If you guys remember when Microsoft, everybody used to be like, man, fucking, can't fucking stand Microsoft, man. They ruined my Xbox. I got a red ring of death and all this other bullshit. You remember that shit? Yeah, I remember that. Fucking, the people, like, forget very, very fast about that. Now, have I ever had a, you know, an Xbox red ring of death on me? No. Because I didn't buy an Xbox until 2009. But, you know, I've had nothing but a quality product from Microsoft here, but Microsoft does have a way of making sure that, you know, you pay a little bit extra, like your digital downloads on Xbox. I've never really understood why they did this, but, it never made sense why the fucking, what do you call that? Like, if I download Borderlands 2 on Xbox, it actually costs the same as if I just bought it from fucking, you know, GameStop. And I'm like, why? I didn't pay for the box, I didn't pay for shipping, I didn't pay for anything. Why is this more expensive? Well, actually the same fucking price. Why? It doesn't make sense. So, you know, it depends how you look at it, man. It all depends how you look at it and what you want out of your, out of the company that you're looking for to purchase from, you know? That's all it is. As a consumer, you just gotta, you gotta buy what is out there for you. What appeals to you best. And, you know, just because, you know, maybe it's an Apple, maybe it's a fucking, you know, maybe it's a PC, maybe it's Samsung, maybe it's fucking, I don't know, fucking iPhones and shit. I don't know, man, it's fucking up to you as a consumer to decide that for yourself. I can tell you, like, from, like, products that I've used before, like, you know, like capture cards and shit, I can tell you that, like, you know, which one I like best. But I mean, what if you like streaming better? So you might actually like, you know, the Avermedia more than the fucking Elgato. And I actually still like my Elgato, but the, you know, when I go ahead and make PC video gameplay, my fucking, what do you call that? Hey! Asshole piece of shit. Yeah. And she die. But anyway, yeah, like I said, fucking, I use my Avermedia when I fucking record, you know, ultra PC gameplay, but when I record on console, I like the Elgato because it helps me save file sizes with the flashback recorded. Even though Avermedia has the flashback recorded, it doesn't do it in the file extension that I like. So, you know, like I said, as a consumer, they're both very good products, but, you know, I can't say which one's better than the other because they're both different. Both different. I think that's the best way to put shit. So, let's move on. Renegade Exile says, do you think they should bring back pearlescent shields to attempt to help balance Ultimate Vault Hunter mode? I mean, honestly, I'd rather just see them fucking fix the goddamn fucking shield scaling right now. Like, I could just, you saw it before, earlier, yesterday. Well, yesterday. Earlier in the video I posted today. I got one shot by a fucking loot midget while I was in Deception. Although I am using a B shield, yes. Should it have killed me in one shot? No. No, there's no reason why I should go in the fucking second win from fucking one hit, you know? One hit? That's fucking retarded. But pearlescent shields would be cool, but I would like them to figure out the balancing just a little bit better in the game. Not really so-called the balancing, but more of the scaling of things to make sure that, you know, things scale properly and everybody's given a very good shot at, you know, playing the same game. So let's move on to Alex Stapleton. Alex Stapleton says, perhaps you should do, what's it called? He said, you should just do a voiceover commentary for your Sunday Q&A Let's Play. And, you know, that way, we can... Oh, shit, that's not good. He's slagged. But, he said, maybe I should do my Q&A post commentary. I used to, but, a lot more people like it better live. And I do know, like you said, you know, there would be less jump cuts in my, you know, in my audio if I did post commentary, because I would be more relaxed and I wouldn't be, you know, responding to what's going on in the game and shit. But I think that's what makes it fun. Like, when a loot midget pops out and it puts me down and I'm like, oh shit, you know, fucking, it's like you guys are right here with me, man. It's like you're right here with me. And I think a lot of people will agree with me that, you know, oh shit, it's Jimmy Jenkins again. God damn. Oh, we gotta kill him one more time. That would be nice to get a little bit of more badass rank. Look at my badass rank. My badass rank sucks balls. It really does. But, oh well. So, yeah, even though the jump cuts are there, fucking... Why? Nobody really minds the jump cuts. Because you know why? Because fucking the rank's too damn high. But no, honestly, like, fucking jump cuts are part of Let's Plays. It happens. Like, you can't expect somebody to sit there and talk for 2 hours straight without stopping to go take a piss. Or, like, tonight, I'm actually eating my dinner while doing my Let's Play for you guys. So, you know, it's sacrifices that we make. But also, I want to keep the integrity of, you know, what my Q&A Let's Play is for. And that's for, you know, playing the video game, answering questions, and reacting to what's going on live. Reacting live. And that's what it's all about. It's all about that interaction, man. Like, you guys are right here with me. All up inside this fucking place. But, anyway. Yeah, let's move on. The Crazy Boy 99 says, do you still talk to your brother? Every now and then, man. We, like I said, we reconnected through YouTube because he found my channel. It was like, oh, shit, look, this is my brother. That's kind of cool. But, I mean, we still probably only talk, like, once every, like, you know, maybe a few months, or I'll stop in on his Xbox party and be like, yo, what's going on, dude? It's like, nothing, just chilling, fucking doing nothing. I'm like, yeah, you know, fucking nothing, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, we go about our ways, we go about our days, and we go about our separate motherfucking ways. Because, you know, we never really grew up together. He left when I was really young, and, you know, I was pretty much, like, for half my life I had a brother, and half my life I haven't. So, I mean, as of now, it's like, you know, he's more of just somebody I know. He's not really, like, you know, I don't feel that connection with him when I talk to him. Like, I don't feel like we're related anymore. It's just like, you know, hey, what's up, bro? What's going on? You know, it's not like, oh, man, you know, I love you so much. I hope nothing bad happens to you because, you know, my brother has done a lot of bad things in life. So if something bad happens to him, he probably, you know, he probably earned that in karma points. He probably did. But anyway, let's move on. Brandon Cutlip says, do you think they should make a second Gotham City Imposters and add a campaign mode? I mean, as cool as that sounds on paper, if it's made by Monolith, no. Because Monolith has fucked up not only fucking, what was that, Aliens vs. Predator, but now they fucked up Gotham City Imposters, and they also fucked up Guardians of the Middle Earth. So, no, they don't get my money for a fourth time. They fucked up enough, so they get nothing! You lose! Good day, sir! Shit. Alright, so the next question is from the Doro Brian 581. He says, what would your old teachers think of you now? I don't know, man. I never really even given a thought to any of these motherfuckers, really. Like, once I started doing my Road to 30, like, I started thinking back about some of my old teachers, and I'm just like, yeah, you know what? You guys are a bunch of fucking scumbags, and I don't want to waste any of my life thinking about what the fuck they give a fuck about what I'm doing. You know why? Because I make more money than most of my teachers do now. And that's not through any, like, fucking YouTube or anything. That's through fucking, you know, the type of life that I built for myself with flipping cars. And fucking, it's actually really cool because, you know, teachers don't make a lot of money. They don't. So when, you know, teachers tell you, oh, you're not going to amount to nothing, bitch, you ain't amounting to shit. You're a teacher. You don't make nothing. And you fucking teachers are just people who got picked on in school. And fucking they want to give everybody else fucking hell because their life fucking sucks and they hate themselves. Fucking that's what teachers are. Bunch of pieces of shit. Oh, man. I am a bad influence, man. What is that? Why am I using a fire burst? I mean, a fucking rubberized fire beam. That is terrible. What the fuck was the point of that? Wow. Wow. You see that? Let's go ahead and fucking give him one of these. Yeah, how do you... Oh, I forgot it's a doll. It's burst fire if I don't fucking... Motherfucker. Yeah, there we go. Good job. How about you get out of my face? Get out of my face, motherfucker. Anyway, next question. Oh, wait, no. Wait, I'm still on this question about teachers. Yeah, teachers suck ass. But, he says, would they think you could do this well? I don't give a fuck what they think. Like I said, they ain't nobody to me, man. Once I got out of school, I've seen a few teachers outside of school when I was like 18, 19, and they were all trying to be nice, like, oh, hi, how you doing? Get the fuck out of my face, you piece of shit. Like, I tell them straight up, like, look, you made my life a living fucking hell, so why don't you stop trying to talk to me out in public, you know? Fucking go fucking get hit in a car crash or something. Get out of my fucking face. Fucking, but, yeah, let's move on before I fucking rant anymore and I start fucking saying things that I regret. Oh, well. So let's move on. J-Rod Football says, kill the power loader. Shit, it's hitting shit back at me. That is not good. Let's, I gotta give him one of these. Yeah, the fist of death, bitch. The fist of death. Oh, whoa. Look at this guy. Where are you gonna go? You're all slagged up. You ain't gonna fucking hide from nobody. Look at you bounce it all over the ground like fucking Winnie the Pooh. Winnie the Pooh, motherfucker. Oh, ow. Ow, you ain't no Chupacabra, bitch. Fucking. Anyway, J-Rod Football says, do you play Total Miner Forge still? I do not. He says, I saw a texture pack on there that was made by you. Yes, little known fact, if you go back through my channel, you will find out that, you know, in the early days, I was actually very well connected with the, not only just Fortress Craft, but a Total Miner. Total Miner. And I've also had some contact with Digital DNA, who did Castle Miner. I wasn't really a big fan of that one, but, you know, it is what it is. It was actually... Castle Miner Z was kind of cool, though. That was kind of a cool game. I played that game, beat the dragon, called it a day, you know, just walked home, fucking ate some fucking chips. I don't know what the fuck I'm saying. I don't know. But, anyway. Yeah, I made a texture pack on there. I don't play it anymore. I got tired of all the Minecraft-style games. I played them so much, man. So much. And I'm just, you know, I'm done with that style of game for now. I do still enjoy Minecraft, but I haven't played it, man. Just haven't had a chance to, you know, really just get down and dirty with it again. Just, kind of just lost my pizzazz for it. My love. I hate fucking saying that, but, you know, Minecraft is a good game. It's just, not for me anymore. Not for me. Hey! I had him grabbed. I grabbed him. Get out of here. There we go. Come on, man. Fucking my shit all up. Fucking my mojo up, bitch. Look at this guy. Look at this. This is dessert. Oh, yeah, baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Suck on my jagon. Fucking stick it in my crusher. Fucking. I love South Park. I really do. Look at this guy. He's a yak slag. He's over here puking and shit. Fucking piece of shit. Stop puking. Stop puking. Go calm your fucking stomach down, you piece of shit. But, yeah, that was my texture pack. I made it to look kind of like, you know, Super Nintendo RPG style, except I didn't realize when I originally made it, because it was my first texture pack, how bright that green was. And, I actually found out the reason that that green was so bright is because the monitor that I was using was actually very, very bright and turned up to high settings. So, yeah, it ended up coming out very, very, very bright. And, if Craig ever updates the game, I'd be interested in fucking... Oh, ow. Ow. That is not good. We are dying our ass off. Where'd he go? Where'd he go? No, can I kill him with the fucking Norfleet? No, he's fucking Shock. That's not gonna work. Why are you using a Shock Norfleet against a Shock Skag? Because that's all I had. He went behind the fucking wall and he wouldn't let me shoot him. That is bullshit. That is fucking yay. But oh well, shit happens, right? That's right. So, the next question isn't really a question. It's actually more of a statement. And it got 32 thumbs up, and I just wanted to point it out. And it's from Batten42, and he said, oh shit. He says, this isn't much of a question, but I love how loyal you are to your subscribers. You never miss a daily upload as long as I've been subscribed, and that's for over a year. And you haven't missed any of these Sunday Q&A Let's Plays either. And the fact that you take a whole day just to record and upload these videos is amazing to him. And I want to thank you. I want to thank you because I do put a lot of work into these videos. I really do. And I hope people enjoy them. I really do. I think it's a very cool hobby. It really is. And as much as like people say, like, oh yeah, fucking YouTube this, YouTube that, you know, Jesus hit me with a wiffle ball bat, fucking, you know, I enjoy it. I enjoy it, and I like where it's going. I like where it's going. I like where we're headed. We're headed into some uncharted waters here, and I like it. I like it. So the next question is from Potato Geats, and he says, what is the strangest thing you've ever eaten? The strangest thing I've ever eaten was sausage made from alligator meat. And I gotta say, it's fucking delicious. It really is. It was kind of like a natural spicy, natural smokiness to it, and I would eat alligator again. I really would. I mean, as weird as that's to say, it's actually very, very tasty. So if you ever have a chance to eat alligator, I highly recommend go eat some fucking alligators, man. It's really good shit. Really good shit. So let's move on. Next question is from Aussie Shouts. And he says, Aussie Shots. He says, hey Jay, do you eat McDonald's? If so, what you get? Yeah, I eat McDonald's every now and then. I try not to make it a habit of, like, fucking eating fast food all the fucking time. Just because, like, you know, fast food will run through you. It'll give you the shits. And, you know, nobody's ever really satisfied after eating fast food. You eat it, afterwards, you're, like, fucking all bloated, like, I'm ready to go take a nap for a couple hours and shit. You know, it's just, you know, I just, whatever, man. I mean, fuck it. It is what it is. But whenever I get there, I tend to eat the chicken nuggets. I like chicken nuggets. Chicken nuggets are my shit. And I call them nuggies. I tell my girlfriend, I'm like, I want some nuggies. And she'll go get me some nuggies. And I yelled at my girlfriend last episode, but she was being highly annoying. So I'm allowed to do that. I'm allowed to do that. She's my girlfriend. And I didn't really yell at her. I was just like, baby, leave me alone. I'm trying to do these videos for my subscribers so people on the internet will love me. Shit. That's crazy. That's fucking crazy. But, the next question is from Beanie Boy 11, and he says, my question is, how long have you been with your girlfriend? Oh, boy. Knocking on this door, eh? This year, it will be either 5 or 6 years. 5 or 6 years we've been together. And he says, why don't you propose? Because ain't nobody got time for that. I'm not a marriage type of guy, man. I'm just, you know, I was engaged to be married at one point in my life, and I'm not anymore. So it is what it is, you know. Fucking, I have this sinking feeling that, you know, marriage never works, and it only ruins things. It really does. It ruins shit for everybody. So I tend not to take place in the you know, establishment of marital values. It's not something that I'm actually a fan of. It's just, you know, I've already been through that before, and, you know, it didn't go well for me. It ended up very, very badly, and, I just been turned off by it ever since, fucking. Just because, you know, like I said, my mom, she married my dad, she did. That's how crazy it is. Like, oh, shit! Holy shit, and he's doing the moonwalk. He's doing the moonwalk. But yeah, like, it didn't work out between my mom and my dad. Fucking, my aunt ended up getting married to my other, to her fucking boyfriend, which is, yeah, you know, he's considered my uncle now, I guess. But, you know, shortly after that, you know, things went to shit for them too. So it doesn't seem like something that, I really want to get myself into is, any type of marriage. And I've talked to my girlfriend about this, and I was like, you know, the only thing that it actually makes sense for us to get married is for, you know, insurance purposes. Like, if she dies, you know, make sure I'm taken care of, or I'm die, she's taken care of, or shit like that. But, you know, we'll cross that bridge when it comes to, you know, setting all that up. But as of right now, it's just, it doesn't make sense. It doesn't fit into our lives. Ain't nobody got time for that. Fucking, that's shit. Ain't nobody got time for that shit. Fucking marriage. But no. I kid, though. It's just, it's something that me and my girlfriend talked, and we don't need a piece of paper to say that we love each other. I think that's the, like, most bullshit fucking scam out there, is that you need a fucking piece of paper to tell somebody, and then we gotta spend fucking $10,000 on a wedding, and I gotta buy a fucking ring that doesn't cost fucking $30, and, you know, it's a bunch of bullshit. You know what me and my girlfriend can do for the same amount of money? We could buy a Corvette. That is amazing, right? See? I talked to my girlfriend about this. It's like, you know, the money that people spend on getting married, we'd be able to use that and actually make our lives better and more comfortable, or have something that we both really want and shit. And my girlfriend likes it when I have a really nice, cool car, because except when I fucking, you know, drive real fast and I take a corner really fast, and sometimes she bumps her head onto the fucking side glass, because, you know, when you're drifting and you're, well, not really drifting, but I would say power sliding around a corner. When you're power sliding around a corner and you don't give a person any warning about it, yeah, heads get hit on glass. It happens. What's over here, motherfucker? Get me out of there. I don't want to see what this relic is. This relic is garbage. You, sir, I hope you have a bad day. But, yeah, that's why we don't get married or nothing like that. It's just, no need, man. There's no need. No need. It's just a bunch of shit that fucking society has cooked up to make me spend more fucking money. Money that I don't want to spend on a piece of fucking paper to tell somebody that I fucking love them. When, you know, nothing says you love a girl more than buying a Corvette for yourself, right? Right? I mean, that's how I feel. Like, she's like, well, why'd you buy this? Like, I bought it for both of us, baby. And she's like, what? How am I gonna enjoy your Corvette? But like, it's a two-seater. Somebody's gotta sit in it with me. Fucking, who wouldn't want to sit in a fucking Corvette with me? You know, right? No? I love fucking with you guys. But no, that's pretty much how I feel. It's how I feel. I'd rather own a Corvette. But, that is fucked up. It really is. I'm such an asshole, but you know what? I don't give a fuck. It doesn't bother me. It doesn't bother me that I'm an asshole, because, you know, like I said, I've been through enough shit in my life to where I've earned a little bit of asshole points. So, Julio Gonzalez says, hey, Mac, when do you Skype with your fans? All the fucking time, man. All the time. People just add me on Skype, and I accept it. And then they send me a message, and I talk to them. I don't talk on voice. If you add me on Skype and you call me, I will block you if you call me, because ain't nobody got time for that. Honestly, there are a lot of security risks on Skype with, you know, accepting calls from people you don't know, and, you know, very, very various transfer of data security holes, and that's why I don't take calls on Skype, but I do text. I text with a lot of people, and, you know, if I'm around, if I'm on Skype, I'll you know, sit there and have a conversation. Sit there and chill and talk. I've talked to many of my subscribers that way, and they said they've enjoyed it. But you know, sometimes it gets annoying because, you know, I'm not there, so I'll come home and I'll have 32 messages from one person, and it'll be like, Mac, you there, Mac? Yo, Mac, yo, check this out. Look at my channel, yo. Look at this link. Yeah, it's just like, I let people add me on Skype so we could talk and have a good time, not so, you know, people can link me their channels and fucking, like, I like watching your videos. Tweet that shit to me, man. Don't clog my Skype up with that shit. Don't spam me on a daily basis. Don't spam me, because you know what? You know what's gonna happen if I come to your video and I like it up? Absolutely nothing. Nobody gives a fuck about the shit that I tweet out. Nobody does. Like, unless it's my shit. Like, I've tweeted out my friends' videos before and shit like that. Silence. Videos from subscribers I thought that were actually pretty good. And, nobody comes. Like, I don't have that type of fucking clout on YouTube to where I can say, check this guy's fucking video out. It's good. And people actually do. No, it's fucking, it doesn't happen. It just doesn't. My channel has never been like that. Just because, you know, I mean, I think what the problem is that I've done it so much for so many people that people just got tired of seeing what I fucking tweet out. Like, that's not mine. So it's just, I've ruined my shoutouts on YouTube by giving so many people shoutouts. If that makes any fucking sense. It kind of does, but it doesn't. But, the next question is from Blind, and he gives me a Mary fuck kill situation. He says, Oprah, Hillary Clinton, or Lindsay Lohan? You gotta fuck one, marry one, kill one. All right, we are marrying Oprah, because Oprah is rich, bitch. You better believe it. Oprah's rich, and that will be my boo. That will be my honey boo. I'll wake up every day next to Oprah and rub her fucking feet. You know why? Because rent's too damn high, and she can afford it. So, we're gonna kill one. We're just gonna kill Lindsay Lohan, because I don't want to say that I would like to kill any political figures on my videos, because that's fucking, you know, that's a one-way trip ticket to fucking Guantanamo Bay, if you ask me. So, we are gonna marry Oprah, fuck Hillary Clinton right in her big teethed mouth, and then I'm gonna pull it out, put it in her ass, and give her another ATM, and, you know, then I'm gonna hang out with Bill afterwards. We're gonna smoke a big doobie and play some saxophone, right? Shit, that sounds like a good plan. Good plan, Mac, good plan. So, the next question, though, from Black Forest Gaming. This is, do you watch Survivor? No. Next question is from Home Depot's Finest. It says, Mac, what brand of shoes do you prefer? Actually, since I am a mechanic, I do wear very, very cheap shoes. I don't like to spend a lot of money on shoes. The most amount of money that I would actually spend on a pair of footwear is for Timberlands. I would pay, you know, the $200 for Tims, because they come with a lifetime warranty, and Timberlands are a very good work boot. And that's what I need. I need a very good work boot. That's not a work boot. It's not a work boot. Let's see. Fuck you, motherfucker. Fuck you, dolphin. Fuck you, a motherfucking a whale. I haven't said that in a while. I haven't said, oh, look at you. What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Oh, you're gonna get shot up like a little bitch. Boop. So, no, actually, the footwear that I wear on most of the daily basis is like a Timberland style boot, or fucking Carhartt's actually a really good brand too. But, that, or, fucking, what else is it? Like, they're kind of like Airwalks. I think they're, like Airwalks, Vans, like little regular black. We used to call them back in the day, we used to call them Bobos. This used to be like, just like plain black shoes, low cut, fucking, you know, just chilling there, just hanging out, having a good time. That's what we call Bobos back in the day, and that's what I wear because, you know, I get dirty a lot, and I don't need to be wearing very expensive shoes when I'm out. I do have a pair of, couple pairs of knockoff Jordans that a company on YouTube sent me that I didn't know they were knockoffs until they told me when I was getting them from them that they were authorized replica dealers. Like, not replicas, but reproductions. Like, you know, of shoes that weren't available anymore, retro reproductions. And they were like, oh yeah, we got fucking Nike on board with this. It's all good, all legit. Then I looked up a little bit and realized that this is a company that I probably shouldn't be fucking with. So, kind of sucks. Kind of sucks, but you know what? That's, it's life. We all make mistakes, and the law states that you cannot willingly accept those products. But I did not willingly or knowingly accept those products. I just fucking, I made a mistake. They sent me some shit, and I contacted them. I said, look, I don't want you guys sending me any more shit. You lied to me, and I don't appreciate it because now you made me look like an asshole to my fucking subscribers. So go fuck yourself. That's pretty much what happened with that. That's a, you know, fucking, I got lied to, and it could have been a mistake that could have ended up, you know, really fucking up my life. Really, nobody wants to go to jail for fucking, you know, goddamn knockoff shoes. Like, could you imagine that? But like, what are you in here for? I stabbed my girlfriend, fucked her mother, you know, shit like that. What are you in here? Fucking fake Jordans, man. Fake Jordans. So, you know, it sucks. I got lied to, and you know, we all get lied to. So it's a good thing that I was able to, you know, spot the flaws in their plan, call them out on it, and just walk away from it. I'm not gonna get involved anymore. You guys are on your own. So yeah, just Timberlands or plain black Bobos, motherfucker. Look at these motherfuckers in here. What are you doing? There's more in here. I see you. Where are you? Oh shit, look at this guy. Yeah, bitch, yeah! Die! There's another motherfucker in here too. Let's just, you know what we're gonna do? Oh shit. We're just gonna, there we go. Alright, E-teching it up, baby. E-teching it up. Oh, whoa. Oh, I had him. Oh, there he is. Come on, you scumbag. There you go. Get in my bubble. But, let's move on to the master, Gon Kalalo. He says, Jay, if you could choose, would you be a boy or a girl? I'm happy with my penis and not bleeding from my sniz once a month. So, I'd say I'd stay a man. I'm happy being 100% man. I like it. But, he says, if you could choose anybody to have sex with you, who would it be? Probably my current girlfriend at the moment. I mean, that's why I'm with her, because I choose her as my partner and my mate. You know, fucking, that's who I chose. That's who I'm with. So yeah, I'm just, you know, I'm not gonna be like, oh yeah, Angelina Jolie, because, you know, even if I choose her, she ain't gonna choose me, motherfucker. So I'm gonna keep it real and say, you know, me and my girl are getting along just fine, and I wouldn't change a goddamn thing between us. Except for I would like to spend a little bit more time with my girlfriend lately. I've been fucking neglecting my fucking boyfriendly duties because, you know, my YouTube has been taken off again, and I've been putting a lot of effort into these videos, getting them out for you guys on time, making sure you have at least 2 videos a day. That is a lot of work when you actually do other shit besides YouTube. And you know, I like I said, I don't make enough on YouTube to even come anywhere near living on YouTube. Like, dude, do you know, man, nowhere near. I got enough to fucking give me some fucking beer a month, man. It's about it. And I'm not complaining either, because I love my monthly beer. But, yeah, it's just, that's how it is, man. That's how it is. But, I mean, I enjoy what I do here on YouTube, and I enjoy hanging out with you guys. So, you know, fuck it, right? Fuck it. That's what it's all about, is just having a little bit of fun. And, you know, me and my girlfriend at the moment are just having a little bit of fun. So, Home Depot's Finest is back. He says, Jay, have you ever waved at someone with blue dentist gloves on before? If so, what was their reaction? No, can't say I have. Can't say I have. But the next question is from Mike McCarty. He says, would you rather be paralyzed from the neck down or dead? I don't want to say, because if that ever happens to me, whatever I say now can actually be held in a court of law. If I was ever to fucking... Is Pomona out here? Is any of these motherfuckers out here? What is that? Rabid Skag? We just stick our head out here. Just take a look. We're just taking a look! Don't fucking hate me. Clash Stalker... No. I don't see him. I don't see him. Is there any out there? No. They're fight... you know, I... Just, yeah, we're gonna... We're just gonna go back this way, because I seen a super badass fucking rack out there. It's like, no. But, yeah, I'm not gonna answer that, because whatever I say here, if I am possibly in a fucking, you know, in that position, then I would be, that would be considered a living will, because there's, you know, proof that I would actually have made that decision at least once in my life. And, you know, I don't want something I say at 6:30 in the morning after being up all night drinking on a live stream with Yoke Slayer. I don't want that to be what decides if I'm gonna be fucking, you know, in a coma or die or whatever. All that stupid shit. Like, that is some real serious shit. So, you know, I think about that, and I'll discuss it with my girlfriend. But as of right now, I got nothing for you, man. I'm sorry. Alright, so the next question comes from the FemD1, and he says, hey Jay, how do you keep your girlfriend off your ass while you're playing for hours? Well, if you watched earlier in yesterday's, well, yesterday, why am I saying yesterday? In fucking earlier in today's video, episode 1 with my Zero, my girlfriend actually peeked her head in here, and she was like, what are you doing? And I was like, god damn it, I'm fucking playing, woman. You know, I take time out of my week to make sure that I at least spend, like, a good night hanging out with her, watching TV, you know, shooting the shit, to make sure that I don't neglect my girlfriend, and I try to make sure that I don't neglect her from my video game hobby, and also from the YouTube hobby, which, you know, go hand in hand, but, you know, I try to make sure that there's enough time for her. Sometimes I can, like, right now, in a very, very, very busy month with the new DLC, Ultimate Bolt Hunter mode, Krieg coming and shit like that, you know, she does realize that there are busy times in my YouTube hobby, and she respects that, and she likes it. She likes my YouTube, which is pretty cool that my girlfriend actually supports what I'm doing, because, you know, most of my older girlfriends that I had, like my baby's mama before when I was like a teenager and shit, a lot of them didn't really support any of the ideas I had. Like, my baby's mama used to laugh all the time when I told her, I was like, you know, I want to be in a band. She's like, you have no talent. And I was like, I can get better. I can practice. She's like, no, you gotta be naturally good to be in a band. Fucking, you'll never make it. And pretty much squashed that dream for me. Pretty hardcorely. Like, would I ever been in a band that would have ever amounted to anything? No. What would have been fun just to be in a band, just to be in a band and have a little bit of memories? Yes, yes it would have. Would we have been the best band in the world? No. Would we have been the worst? No, I mean, fucking, we couldn't have been any worse than Limp Bizkit. I mean, seriously, fucking, that's, it's not hard to fucking be better than Limp Bizkit or Nickelback. Fucking, I'm pretty sure we could have pulled that off easily. Fucking, but yeah, you know, it just fucking sucks, but my girlfriend now that I have very much supports what I do, and she has fun with it. She has come on as a guest before for Slender, so you know, that was fun for her. She really liked that. And there's a new Slender out or coming out, I'm not sure, but my girlfriend really wanted to come back on for a couple episodes for that, so maybe I'll have her back on. But the last time I did, people were making comments about her age, or like, are you sure you're not doing this dual comm with your mom, shit like that, because my girlfriend is 20 years older than me. But you know what, I love her, and I love her very much, and I don't let, oh, look, see, you know what, look at this, see these two guns right here that are standing up, a lot of people were giving Yoat Slay a shit, because they said the dropped guns were standing up. So, I'm probably gonna cut this out right here. I'm gonna mark this down. What is this? 2:13. 2 hours 13. I'm gonna write that to Yoat. I'm gonna take that clip and I'm gonna send this to him. And he can put this on his channel and be like, boom, motherfucker. Look at that. Two guns standing up, legitimately dropped. There is no way anybody can say that that's not a legitimate drop. That's, you've seen it right here. Seen it right here. So, a lot of people that do hate on fucking other YouTubers out there, I want to help them dispel the hate. So I'll send that to Yoat and be like, yo, there you go. I got video evidence proof of this shit happening. Because, you know, a couple, like, they said his Logan's gun didn't drop because he fucking, the gun was standing up like that. And it's like, fucking, he said, well, I don't have any proof of anything else otherwise, but, you know, that's what it is. And you know what? I'll be glad to help assist him. To be like, bow! Right to the fucking people and just bow them. If you don't know what bowing somebody is, it's when you're like, when somebody says that you're fucking wrong, and you prove them wrong, and you prove yourself right, you say, bow! In your face, motherfucker. Bow. That's what I'm talking about. So I'm talking, bow, bitch, bow. Fucking, anyway, let's move on from the bowing. No more bowing. Anyway, so we're gonna go ahead and say that, you know, my girlfriend is cool with my YouTube because I try to make sure that we have time to spend together. And, you know, right now, like I said, I play a lot of times when she's sleeping. That's one of the reasons why I do play at like 2, 3 in the morning, is because she's supposed to be, you know, she wakes up really early. And, you know, I really don't run on a schedule at all. I run on my own schedule. So, I mean, I can just stay up, play while she's sleeping, and then fucking go to sleep in the morning. And, you know, fucking, you know, one, by the time she comes home, I have my videos up, they're fucking uploaded for you guys, I've already taken care of the shit I need to take care of during the day, and I got a couple hours of sleep, and, you know, it seems to be working out, it seems to be working. So, the next question, though, is from, purple is shitty, that's a shitty purple, what is that, that's a value handgun, that's not a value, it's $45,000 for that piece of shit. I can get a fucking Rex that's level 50 with the same fucking goddamn fucking damage. You see that shit? Bullshit. So, the next question though is from the best Bradders. He says, Mac, if you had twins, what would you name them, boy and girl? I actually had to think about this. Oh! Oh, I seen it. What was it? Oh! Oh, it's level 59, you scumbag. I think Gearbox nerfed these midgets. To drop, that's what they were trying to do. When they were, remember when they were fucking, you know, when the loot midgets didn't drop, they didn't fucking come out or anything. I think that's what they did. They made everything out of here come level 59. That way, like, yeah, you'll get your fucking legendary drops, motherfucker, but it ain't gonna be particularly useful for ya. Not useful at all. So, let's go ahead and, well, we got to wait for a cooldown. So, yeah, I actually had to think about this because I did knock up a girl back in high school when I was, like, 16 or 17. She was like, oh, what is that? I didn't even see that. Max health, SMG, pistol damage. That is, fucking, that's not damage, that's ammo. I don't need that. I picked up a better one with my zero. Let's go ahead and just kill this motherfucker, though. Oh, there he is. There he is. Hey! Cut punch! He didn't drop shit. What is that? Fucking trash ass boxes. Bullshit! So, let's go open this box over here. Hopefully we get a loot midget in it. If we don't, whatever. Shit happens, right? Let's go! Come on, loot midget! You scumbag. So, that's it for this episode. I'm gonna end up... We have, like, four more questions, actually. And I'll answer them for you on the way back to saving and quitting. But I think we had a little bit of fun with this loot midget. Now that I'm level 61 and it's easier for me to farm these without fucking, getting our ass kicked, it's a little bit more relaxing and just kind of chill. Maybe I'll do another one of these next weekend. We'll never know. Maybe I'll do one Borderlands episode and then one fucking, loot midget episode. Maybe I'll do Dead Island Riptide. You never know. But to answer the best Bradder's question, yes, I actually did knock up a girl back when I was 16, 17. She was pregnant with twins, and she ended up having a miscarriage or an abortion. I think she actually had an abortion, but she told me miscarriage. But she was quite a scumbag, this bitch. Not like scummy, dirty, but she was quite a bitch. They were both girls, the twins, and I'm pretty sure, right? Yeah. I don't know, all I know is that if I had twins, the girls would have been named Isabel and Annabelle, but I think that's a cool name, and if I had a boy and a girl, then I have no idea what I'd name them. Maybe I would name them both Terry, and that would be funny. That would be fucked up, wouldn't it? But no, let's move on. Okilla says, you know what, we're gonna... Why am I in here? I'm going back to Sanctuary. Why am I saving in the Exploitation Preserve? I don't want to be here. But Okilla says, I don't know if you didn't like... He goes, I know you didn't like Far Cry 3, but have you seen Far Cry 3 Blood Dragon? And if so, would you think $15 is worth it? No. Oh, shit. It's Tumba! Yeah, baby. Woo! Alright, what's going on? Oh, it's Pimone! It's a Pimone! Yeah, baby! Oh, we got the ride together, die together fucking challenge. That is beast. That is actually a fucking Bad Boys reference to Will Smith, Martin Lawrence. What is he doing out here? What is he doing out? Oh, motherfucker. Did they drop any legendaries? No. No, why am I even here then? Let's get away from these motherfuckers. See you later, bitches. Later, bitches. What is that up there? That's gross. Can I shoot that? No. I've never even noticed that before. It's fucking gross. Yeah, baby. Die. I missed every one of those bullets, which is not like me. Actually, it's perfectly like me. But let's go. Let's throw... Oh! Why am I... Oh, I got hit by a pestilent stalker. You piece of shit. Go eat that rack. But no, I didn't like Far Cry 3, and it's not because of, like, the story and shit, which it was still pretty piss poor, but Far Cry 3, I didn't like it because the mechanics of the game felt bad. It didn't feel like, a really good game to me, and I don't care how fucking, how much work they've done to the game, it's still Far Cry, and the Far Cry game and the controls suck balls, so... No, I'm not going to buy a game that I was already dissatisfied with it just because they gave it a makeover and some fucking dinosaurs. As much as I like dinosaurs, Far Cry 3, you failed to... Far Cry 3 failed so hard for me that I can't even buy it to enjoy it as a dinosaur game. That's how bad it is. That's how bad it is in my opinion. So the next question is from the Master Guncalo, and he says, Mac, do you know Yoat Slayer? Actually, I do. I do, and he's a very quality human being. We were on live stream last night. If you go to Yoat Slayer's channel and you check out the last two drunken... Well, one of them was drunken, the other one wasn't, because he got drunker as the night went on. But if you watch those two videos, I make a cameo appearance in about an hour and maybe about 2 hours of each video. So if you want to go and, hear me fuck around with Yoat Slayer and Nicole, go ahead and check that out. I'm not going to be uploading it because I didn't record it. And... I'm not gonna ask Goat Slayer for footage off his channel. It's just there's a fucking no reason to do that when you can just go to his channel and watch it there. I'm pretty sure if you're asking about it, you're probably subscribed to him, and if you're not, you can still go there and watch a video that I'm in and enjoy it, right? I think so. I think that's fine, and it doesn't make any sense. Makes no sense, because I ain't nobody got time for that. Let's move on. Why did I go to the badass creator of Badass Institute? Motherfucker! God damn it. So, yeah. Next question is from Skullhands FB. It says, Jay, do you like working on a lathe or a mill? What is your favorite material to work with? Let me get this straight. When I am a mechanic, but I don't do any fabrication. I'm not a fabricator. I'm more of like, you know, the grunt work. Fucking working under hood, electrical wire, diagnostics, fucking rear ends, fucking, you know, brakes, shit like that. So, you know, I don't work with any metal or weld any metal. I'm actually a very terrible welder. And the only thing I would ever trust myself to weld would be exhaust. I'm not going to go ahead and weld your fucking cracked frame because I don't have that type of fucking, you know, skill and or knowledge or experience. And I don't want to put anybody's life at risk. So I know my limitations. I know where I stand with mechanical work. And one day in the future, I will, you know, want to get into that. But I don't right now. It's just it hasn't come across for me. So I'm sorry to disappoint you. I thought that was Michael. Michael was just hauling ass. Fucking A. Let's go take a look if we can't find him real quick. But the next question is going to be from Tyler Short and Iconoclast XV22 said, have you heard about the guitarist Jeff Hanneman dying of Slayer? Yes. Yes, I've heard. Slayer is actually one of my favorite bands. Jeff Hanneman, Kerry King, fucking Arroyo, all those guys, man. Real big fucking influences in my life. And to hear that one of them has passed not only saddens me, but it makes me feel old to know that, you know, like, fucking the years of drinking caught up. I think it's like I heard something about, like, liver or kidney failure. I do know that, you know, Jeff Hanneman was dealing with some type of, like, a necrotizing fasciitis for a while there on his arm. He had some type of flesh-eating bacteria, which is not good. I don't know if that contributed to it, but I do know he was a very hard partier, and, you know, the years caught up to him, and it's a shame. It really is. So, you know, R.I.P. Jeff Hanneman. I hope... I don't even know if they would ever be, like... I mean, it would be fitting to find somebody that can shred just as good, toss them in there, and still play... But I mean, it will never be the same. It'll never be the same again. So, R.I.P. Jeff Hanneman. He entertained millions of people. He really did. So, couldn't have been that bad of a person, right? Couldn't have been that bad. So, it's a terrible situation for the, you know, the world of metal. And, you know, I was actually a little choked up. Like, I didn't cry over it or anything, but, like, you could probably hear it in my voice. Like, I felt the same way when Dio died, man. Like, because both of these guys are people that are, like, huge legends in metal and music, and they never got their due. Like, nobody ever fucking, like, everybody was always, like, you know, when it comes to Slayer, they're like, Kerry King, fucking Arroyo, fucking, those are the two guys everybody always mentions. Nobody ever mentions Jeff Hanneman, and, you know, now that they're mentioning and they're getting their dues, it's a shame to say that they couldn't be around to see the type of respect that people had for them, especially Dio. So, you know, fucking, I guess, it is what it is, man. It is what it is, and I just wish some people would get to live to see their legend be made. You understand what I'm saying? Like, that's same thing with artists, like, people that paint and shit. Like, their shit ain't worth money while they're living, but when they die, it goes up in price. It's like, God damn it. You know, why can't this person just enjoy a life of being a good artist? It's a shame. It really is. So, that's it. That's it for the questions. And, my name is Jay. More than Afterkill. I want to thank you guys for watching. If you could throw a thumbs up on a video, I would highly appreciate it because it gives me motivation to make more videos for you motherfuckers that watch my motherfucking videos. And also, like I said, please leave a comment or a question down below, and I will answer it next week, as long as it's not something that I asked or answered millions of motherfucking times, like what type of food do you like, what's your favorite food, what's your favorite song, or, you know, a lot of Borderlands 2 questions. Really, I've answered them a lot in my Ultimate Vault Hunter Mode series, so if you really have any questions about Borderlands, or you want to see, like, you know, what I think about a certain area, or gun, or whatever, you know, I pretty much title the videos, so if you played Borderlands 2, you can go through my Ultimate Vault Hunter, you know, playlist, and you can look and be like, oh, well, he's fighting Saturn in this video, I know where he is in the storyline, oh, he's fighting Boom Boom, this boss fight, Mad Mike, you know, oh, it's really easy to find out where I am in my fucking Let's Play, so if you need help on a certain situation, or you're trying to find, like, an area, maybe fucking see what you're doing wrong, or what I'm doing wrong, or just have a good laugh. That's what it's there for, man. That's what it's there for. And I try to title them and tag them so everybody can find what they're looking for very, very easily. So, like I said, thanks for watching. My name is Jay, More Than Afterkill. Make sure you guys rate, comment, subscribe. I want to thank you guys for watching. If you could throw a thumbs up on the video, I would highly appreciate it. And I'm going to see you guys later.